Hi. You went on Question Time, it was probably about 6 weeks ago, and there was a bloke in the audience, and he tried to start a parable about having £10 at the end of the week and going to the pub and buying 4 pints. Mm-hmm. And you explained to him correctly that his, you know, personal life wasn't a very good model for economics. But his personal life has been used as a model for economics by, yes, particularly exactly, in this country, by the Conservative Party. And I just wanted to ask why you thought the centre-left and the left in this country and in Europe has failed so spectacularly, really, to debug that myth.
Well, thank you for this question. It's true. It's the short answer to your question is because the left has lost its mojo some time ago. We have, especially the Labour left in this country, the Social Democrats in my country, in France, in Germany, for some reason, which is the topic of another lecture, lost their anti-establishment critical capacity or energy, since I was referring to an anti-establishment energy. They were far more interested in being admitted into the corridors of power and into polite society than in changing the world. George Bernard Shaw once said that of course, he was being ironic, that the reasonable people adapt themselves to the world. Well, the left was meant to be unreasonable, trying to adapt the world to its views of what the world ought to be like. And the left lost that. So Tony Blair was much more interested in being considered a good conservative boy than changing Britain, or changing it in a way that is consistent with the Labour Party. But on the question of this gentleman, okay, he sounded a bit crass, but you're right. The main point he was making is one which is dominant around the world to this day. It's dominant in the Republican Party in the United States. It's dominant even in the socialist parties of Europe. The idea of belt-tightening, of austerity. Now, let me make one thing abundantly clear here. I believe in austerity. Is it startling? I do believe in austerity at a personal level, at a level of a family, at a level of a shop, at a level of a company. So when your income shrinks and suddenly you are in the red and you can't make ends meet, you've got to tighten your belt. If you don't tighten your belt, you will go bankrupt. So prudence should guide you towards austerity at a personal level. But the point that you raised and I raised and we ought to raise all the time, and George Osborne understands it. It's not that he doesn't understand. That's why I've defended him in a way that maybe he doesn't like, but nevertheless, I defended him. The point is that the reason why austerity works, belt tightening works at the personal level, is because there is a strict independence between your outflows and your inflows, your income and your expenditure. So if tonight you don't have a pint, you abstain from having a pint. How much is a pint these days? £4. Okay, let's say £4. You've saved £4. Your income, the amount of money you have in your pocket, doesn't shrink, doesn't increase, stays the same. You just have £4 more, right? But at the level of a macroeconomy, that's why I kept talking macroeconomics in the Eurogroup, and I was being blamed for insisting of talking economics in the Eurogroup. You know, the mind boggles. At the macroeconomic level, in an economy, take Britain. In an economy like Britain, total expenditure equals total income. So my expenditure is your income, if I'm buying something from you. So our total expenditure equals our total income. So suddenly there is a complete breakdown in the independence between expenditure and income. So what happens during a crisis is this. It happened in 2008 with the credit crunch, with the implosion of Wall Street, the City of London, and so on. People start fearing, they cut down on spending, debt becomes unsustainable if the debt bubble implodes and all that. What happens is corporations and households, seeing that now they are in trouble, they stop spending. They deleverage, in the language of the financial press. So the private sector as a whole, families, individuals, companies, spend less on investment, on expenditure, on cars, on airplanes, on everything. Yeah, they spend. So there is a shrinkage of private expenditure. If the state, which now suddenly suffers a widening budget deficit, why? Because as private expenditure shrinks, the tax take of the government comes down. At the very same time, usually there's an increase in unemployment, so unemployment benefits are more costly for the government, so the government's expenditure goes up during a crisis, and its tax take comes down. So the budget rises. So if suddenly you panic and you try to apply the principles that of austerity that work at the private level, you try to apply this at the governmental, macroeconomic level, what happens is, while private expenditure shrinks, public expenditure shrinks. What's the sum of these two, private and public expenditure? It's total income. So total income is going to shrink faster if the if at the macroeconomic level the government goes austerian. This is why austerity doesn't work. George Osborne knows that because he tried a little bit of austerity when he was elected, and the nascent recovery that he inherited from the last months of Brown went down, and he stopped doing it.